Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. A warm welcome to all of you joining us for the Sunday Angelus, led by Pope Francis here in St. Peter's Square. Of course, you're seeing images live in the square right now on this sunny and warm August, this the 21st Sunday in Ordinary Time. And here we are gathered and waiting on Pope Francis to appear from the window there of the Apostolic Palace there with the tapestry hanging from it there. We have pilgrims from around the world here visiting the Eternal City, as well as locals who come out to the square on occasion here for the Sunday Angelus and to receive the Pope's blessing, which will be going out as well to all of you joining us here live. And as usual, a special welcome to all of you, and especially those broadcasters who link up with us in a special way, including Catholic TV, the Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light Television, EWTN Television, Radio Maria England, Shalom Television India, Atmar Darshan Television India, and Luminous Radio India. And of course, welcome to all of you joining us on our Facebook Live feed, our live YouTube stream, which can be viewed from YouTube, and of course, via VaticanNews.va. And by the way, the Angelus Prayer, as we've often mentioned, can be found by clicking Pray with the Pope on the Angelus tab on the Vatican News website or the app. August traditionally here in the Eternal City is a pretty quiet time, and Pope Francis, his public events include the Wednesday audiences held inside due to the heat and the Paul VI Audience Hall in the Vatican, and the Sunday Angelus when he leads the recitation of the Marian Prayer here in St. Peter's Square, open to all the public, as is the Wednesday General Audience. In recent days, he's called attention to various world events, of course, Ukraine, praying for peace, praying for an end to the violence there. He's drawn attention as well to humanitarian situations that require international help and our prayers and support, including Somalia, in particular the Horn of Africa, where extreme drought has led to a very high risk of a serious famine there. The Pope's also called attention to how, unfortunately, in our world, war diverts attention and resources from what should be our utmost highest objectives and commitment to fight against hunger and to promote health and education. And while the month of August has been relatively quiet, it will be quite busy coming up soon here. At the end of this month, Pope Francis will be creating 21 new cardinals at a consistory on Saturday, August 27th. That will be broadcast live, of course, by us. The applause you're hearing in the square there, of course, is for Pope Francis, who's appearing at that window there, just to let our radio listeners know what's happening there.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buona domenica.
Dear brothers and sisters, a good Sunday to you all. In the passage from the Gospel of Luke for this Sunday's liturgy, someone asks Jesus, "Will those who are saved be few?" And the Lord responds, "Strive to enter through the narrow door." The narrow door is an image that could scare us, as if salvation is destined for only a few elect or perfect people. But this contradicts what Jesus taught on many other occasions. And as a matter of fact, a little further ahead, he confirms, "People will come from east and west and from north and south and recline at table in the kingdom of God." Therefore, this door is narrow, but it's open to everyone. Never forget that. It's open to everyone. The door is open to all. But to better understand, we need to ask what this narrow door is. Jesus was using an image from contemporary life, most likely referring to the fact that when evening would fall, the doors of the city would be closed, and only one, the smallest, would remain open. To return home, someone could get through only there. Now let's think about when Jesus says, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved. He wants to tell us that to enter into God's life, into salvation, we need to pass through Him, to welcome Him and His Word. Just as to enter into the city, someone had to measure, the same as the only remaining open, narrow door. So too, the Christian door is a life whose measure is Christ, founded and modeled on Him. This means that the rule of measure is Jesus and His gospel, not what we think, but what He says to us. So we're talking about a narrow door, not because only a few are destined to go through it, but because to belong to Christ means to follow Him, to live one's life in love, in service, and in giving oneself as He did, who passed through the narrow door of the cross. Entering into God's proposal for our life requires that we restrict the space of egoism, reduce the presumption of self-sufficiency, lower the heights of pride and arrogance, overcome laziness in order to cross through the risk of love, which even involves the cross. Let's think concretely about those daily acts of love that we struggle to carry on with. Let's think of parents who dedicate themselves to their children, making sacrifices and renouncing time for themselves. This is the narrow door. Let's think of those who concern themselves about others and not only about their own interests. There's so many good people like that. Let's think of those who spend themselves in service to the elderly, to the poorest, and the most vulnerable, to those who keep on working committedly, putting up with discomfort and perhaps with misunderstanding, to those who suffer because of their faith, but who continue to pray and love, to all who, rather than following their own instincts, respond to evil with good, finding the strength to forgive and the courage to begin again. These are only a few examples of people who do not choose the wide door of their own convenience, but the narrow door of Jesus, of a life spent in loving. The Lord says today that the Father will recognize them much more than those who believe they are already saved, but who are actually workers of evil. Brothers and sisters, which side are we on? Do we prefer the easy way of thinking only about ourselves? Or do we choose the narrow door of the gospel that puts our selfishness into crisis, but which makes us able to welcome the true life that comes from God? Which side are we on? May Our Lady, who followed Jesus all the way to the cross, help us to measure our life with Him so as to enter into the fullness of eternal life.
Et concepite de Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus Tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Ut digni efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut angelum annunciante Christi Fili tui, incarnatione cognovium, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamus. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, Requiem aeternam donei Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a Teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit celum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen. Fratelli e sorelle,
brothers and sisters,
seguo da vicino con preoccupazione e dolore la situazione creatasi in Nicaragua.
I'm following the situation in Nicaragua with concern and worry. I wish to express my hope that there will be a sincere dialogue and that a basis for respectful living together can be found in Nicaragua. I pray that the Lord may inspire the concrete will to dialogue in Nicaragua to find a solution to the difficulties there. And I greet all the Romans and visitors here who are gathered and associations who are gathered here in the square. And I greet those from the North American College gathered here in Rome, especially the new seminarians who've just arrived. And I exhort you in your ministry and in your time here, and I greet as well other groups present in the square to witness to the joy and love of Christ. And I greet, of course, the faithful here gathered from Verona and other parts of Italy, and as well the group from the Camino Via Lucis who are helping the poor and those living in difficulty. And of course, the Ragazzi dell'Immacolata, the various groups and parish groups involved in different ministries. And we pray, of course, for all those in Ukraine who are living through such cruelty and suffering. Have a good Sunday, and please remember to pray for me. Have a good lunch, and arrivederci. And Pope Francis now waving to the crowds those concluding words after giving his apostolic blessing there, following the recitation of the Angelus, calling us to keep Nicaragua in our prayers and the tensions that are there, as well to remember Ukraine and to pray for peace, throughout the world, of course. And he also offers his special greetings to the various associations gathered in the square. You can see them with their banners waving there, involved in the church's ministry and outreach, charitable outreach, and as well in pilgrimage here to the Eternal City. That draws us to a conclusion here. Thank you all for joining us on this sunny Sunday here in August in the Eternal City. We'll be back again Wednesday with the Wednesday General Audience, and at the end of the week again, we have the Consistory and many other broadcasts coming up. So be sure to check it all out on our website, vaticannews.va, and our social media profiles, Facebook, and of course, Twitter, for all the latest. A blessed Sunday to you all. Praise be Jesus Christ, Laudetur Jesus Christus.